Russia has launched a fresh round of deadly missile attacks on Ukraine. The Ukrainian military says the eastern cities of Kramatorsk, Krasnoyarnivka, and Pavlograd were targeted in the attacks, along with another region. Ukraine's air defense forces intercepted 15 of 18 Russian cruise missiles. At least 25 people, including three children, were injured in the latest attacks as the missiles hit a residential area in the city of Pavlograd, damaging homes, schools, and stores. Russia has intensified its missile attacks on Ukraine in the past few days. Over in South America, conservative economist Santiago Peña wins Paraguay's presidential election, diffusing fears about the end of the country's ties with Taiwan. With almost all ballots counted, Peña, who has vowed to maintain diplomatic relations with the self-ruled island, received over 42% of the votes. That's a 15-point lead over his center-left rival Efrain Alegre, who in contrast proposed to drop Paraguay's long-running relationship with Taiwan and argued for switching allegiance to China. Paraguay is currently among the 14 countries which have official diplomatic relations with Taiwan, as the island faces growing military threats from China, which claims Taiwan as its own. New York this weekend witnessed the latest addition to its uptown gala scene in the form of a fundraising event for medical debt relief. The first ever debt gala took place Sunday, featuring attendees in fashion items utilizing recycled, sustainable, or upcycled materials. Similar to the Met Gala, it's inspired by, the debt gala was a red carpet event with a variety show and a dance party lined up in the evening. According to organizers, the goal of the event was to fundraise for the most vulnerable Americans. That's how they came to collaborating with nonprofit group RIP Medical Debt, who works to eliminate financially burdensome medical debt.
One of my co-founders, Molly, her fiance, Layla, told us about this amazing charity called RIP Medical Debt, which buys and relieves medical debt for people all over the country. And I learned since planning this event that medical debt is the number one cause of debt amongst Americans. And we thought if the money from this event is going to go anywhere, it should go to people most in need. So we chose medical debt as our charity and aligned with RIP. And that's where the money from all of the tickets proceeds tonight are going and all of our donations.
An update now on the power outage that hit Metro Manila's main gateway. Joyce Palancho joins us for the details. Joyce, go ahead.
Yes, Ron, sa mga oras na to, 4:20 ng hapon, wala na namang kuryente dito sa NAIA Terminal 3. Kani-kanina lamang mga 10 minutes ago, nawalan muli ng kuryente dito sa terminal. Ibig sabihin, hindi na muli gumagana yung mga scanners sa bawat pintuan ng terminal, kaya hindi pa muli nagpapapasok ng mga pasahero sa mga oras na to for security reasons. Kahit yung mga miyembro ng media na naiwan dito sa labas, hindi rin kami muna makapasok sa loob kasi mahigpit pa rin ang seguridad dito sa Terminal 3 at kailangan dumaan sa mga scanners yung mga dalang, mga bagahe at mga bags ng mga pasahero. Wala pang ibinibigay na dahilan sa amin ang pamunuan ng Terminal 3, maging yung mga airport authorities na nandito at mga police, kung bakit nagkaroon mo rin ng aberya sa supply ng kuryente dito sa terminal. Ang sabi lamang ng general manager ng MIAA na si general manager Cesar Chong ay ipapacheck pa niya yung sitwasyon dito at kung ano muli ang naging sanhi ng aberya. Hinihingi pa rin tayo ng, sa mga panahon na to ng updates mula sa airline companies kung ano ang panibagong epekto nito sa operasyon ng kanilang mga flights. Yan muna ang huling balita mula dito sa Terminal 3 sa NAIA. Ron?
Joyce Balancho with that story. Joyce reporting that there's no electricity at the NAIA Terminal 3. That was around 4 in the afternoon. Passengers not being allowed to enter the terminal again because they can't use the scanners because there's still no electricity. Joyce will still try to get any new information on what caused this new power outage, a second for the day.